Hello guys, my name is Jibran and today our topic is block account in Germany. Recently a few students reached me on Instagram and asked me which is the best block account in Germany. In today's video, I will tell you all the platforms which are recognized by German government and you can open a block account with them in just few minutes. So first let me answer the simple question that you might already know the answer to, that what is the block account? Well, if you want to come to Germany as a student or a job seeker, then you have to send your first year monthly expenses to the German bank account. This is kind of a security for you and a German government that when you come here, then you have enough money to sustain yourself for a year. At the end of the video, I will also mention some tips for the second year expenses for students in Germany. As of 2021, you need to have 861 euros per month for your expenses in your block account. So if you are coming to Germany as a student, then you need to transfer 1 year expenses, which is 10,332 euros in your block account. Many students have this misconception that the money gets unblocked once you reach Germany. Yes, it gets unblocked, but only the first 861 euros which you needed for your first month expenses, and then the next month, second month, 861 euros get unblocked. This way, after 12 months, the whole 10,332 euros gets unblocked, which means that it takes 1 year till you get all your money back. You can't unblock it all at once. Then you might also ask if there is any way to get a German visa without the block account. So if you have a sponsor in Germany, then you can ask them to give you the sponsorship letter. Or if you have a scholarship, then you can give the scholarship letter instead of the block account. I have already made a detailed video about DART scholarships in Germany. You can find the link in the description and check out those videos. Just for your info, if you're coming to Germany as a tourist or coming on work visa, then you also don't need this block account. Besides the block account, you also need the German health insurance for your visa extension in Germany, and also the travel insurance. Some of the providers, which I will mention in a moment, these platforms also offer health insurances. So if you don't want to go anywhere else, then you can also buy the package from those platforms where you get a block account and also the German health insurance. One pro tip here, sometimes your local travel insurance does not work well in Germany. So if you have a travel insurance from these platforms, then at least you know that it is going to work in Germany. Then you don't have any problem using that insurance. Now about the platforms. According to my knowledge, there are four platforms where you can open a block account. The one I used in 2014 is the Deutsche Bank, and they are still following the old procedure where you have to send the attested document and the form, and then they open an account. And it takes more time to open an account with Deutsche Bank than with other three platforms. These three platforms are Expectario, Coracle and Fintiba. All of them are digital platforms, so you can easily open a block account with them. So let me first tell you about Expectario. This platform was founded in 2017 and they offer all services that you need as a student or as a job seeker when you're coming to Germany. For example, you get 92 days free travel insurance, which is needed for your visa. Then they also help you to get the public health insurance from TK, which is in German is called TK, and also gives you the free ISEC student card for 1 year. If you're a student, then I would highly recommend this card because it gives you discount at many places like Flixbus, Flixtrain, many museums all around the Europe. So it is highly recommend. So Expectario charges 49 euros as a setup fee, and they also charge 5 euros service fee monthly, and you need to deposit this amount with your block account. There is a way that you can waive this 49 euros setup fee if you also add the health insurance during your sign up. The health insurance depends on different factors like your age, so it could vary for different people, but it is around 110 euros per month. Here are some of the advantages of Expectario. Number one, it is approved by German Foreign Office and you get the German IBAN under your name. Number two, you can open an account in just few minutes. They also have 24-hour customer service. Number three, if your visa is rejected, then you can get all your money back, including your service fee. Number four, after 1 year, you can also cancel your contract with just 1 month's notice period. Number five, they also have so many blogs for the new students on their website, which help new students in the starting days, like, for example, life in Germany, work in Germany, job in Germany, accommodation, and many other stuff. After Expectario, I have Coracle. They were founded in 2016. They also offer block account and health insurance. They have really good customer service and they also offer customer service in different languages. Coracle charges a 99 euro setup fee for the block account and they don't have any monthly fee. If you're coming here as a bachelor or a master student, then you can pay only 59 euros for the prime package, which includes block account, free 6 months travel insurance, and also free sign up for the public insurance. Unlike Expectario, they offer three public insurance companies, which are AOK, Balmer and TK. In comparison to Expectario, the Coracle is the cheapest option and their website is also very straightforward. They don't offer any other information blogs like the one we saw on Expectario. Coracle benefits are also the same as Expectorio, that they are recognized by a foreign office and all. The one thing which was not available in Expectorio but Coracle offers is that you can also send more than 10,332 euros to your Block account if you want. Last company I have is Fintiba, which was founded in 2016. Why they are different from other services is because of their app-based service. You can simply open an account using their app and upload all the necessary documents. You do not need to go to their website. Just a simple mobile phone will do all the things. If you open an account with Fintiba, then you need to legitimize yourself, which you can either do using PostIdent once you're in Germany, or you can use the Verify You platform. Like others, Fintiba also offers the Plus package where you can get the Block account, free travel insurance for your visa, and also the public insurance with DAK. Besides this, they also offer the complete community-based platform for students where students can find scholarships and many other things which helps other students as well. This Plus package also has a setup fee for 89 euros, and they also charge 4.9 euros monthly, which they charge from the day the money reaches Fintiba bank. Fintiba has all the advantages that I mentioned for Coracle and Expectorio. Here you can also deposit more than recommended Block account, and with their value package you can get the ISEC card for 3 years. It seems like Fintiba is the most expensive option than all three, but each come with their own packages and offers, so you can now select which one suits you the best. Last, many people ask me this question, that how to transfer money from my home country to Germany. This depends on the resources that you have in your country. For example, I am from Pakistan and I know only two ways to transfer the money to the Germany. One is that you send the money via any local money exchanges, and another way is that you open a foreign country account in euros and then transfer it using that FC account. Another pro tip here for upcoming students to Germany. Recently I have collaborated with Wise, and they told me that you can open a euro account without being in Europe. It is a perfect opportunity that you can open a free euro account with Wise, and you can also transfer some money to that bank account. This way you can also use their Google and Apple Pay services to pay for things like your first train ticket in Germany, or when you are going to supermarket, or anywhere where you can pay using your phone is totally acceptable. Nowadays you can pay anywhere using your phone as long as you have a mobile phone which supports this feature. I have mentioned that I will give you a pro tip that how you can avoid next year's Block account. Well, in most cities students do not need to show the Block account for the second year, but you still need to show some money in your bank account to get the visa for the second year. There are a couple of ways to do that. Let's say that after 1 year you have around 3,000 euros in your Block account or your bank account, and also have a mini job contract, then the Ausländer Behörde easily extends your visa for the next year. And even if you don't have much money in your bank account, but you have a student job where you are earning around 700 to 800 euros, you can still show this job contract and get the visa extension. Another way to get the visa extension, if you get a sponsorship letter from your sponsor, like suppose if your father is supporting you financially, then you can ask him to get the stamped paper from your country, and on that paper it is written that he will support you monthly with 861 euros and he will take care of your expenses and all the things that is related to this. Then you can show this letter to Ausländer Behörde to get the visa extension. This also works in many cities. If you are coming here as a student, then I have already made many videos for students in Germany, like suppose like student jobs in Germany, driving license in Germany, DART scholarship, exchange programs, best credit card in Germany, best SIM card in Germany, and many more stuff. So you can watch my other videos if you're interested in such topics. Now, one last thing, that I have already added all the links in the description of all these banks that I just mentioned, so you can go through them and decide which platform suits you the best and where you want to open your Block account. So you can watch my other videos if you're interested in such topics. Now, one last thing, that I have already added all the links in the description, like the banks and other stuff, so you can go through them and decide which platform suits you the best. Now, if you have any questions, then feel free to comment below. I will happy to answer them, and also do subscribe my channel. See you next time in another video. Till then, ciao ciao.